In this lesson, I want to show you another way to select elements, which is selecting by class. We are going to start with an empty style sheet and a different example on HTML, which is just an unordered list with a few items. What I want to do is paint green all the elements that are vegetables. So that would be spinach, carrot, and cucumber. And I want to paint brown all the elements that are meat. So how can we do that? We could select by tag, by li tag, but that would select all the elements. If I used the selection by id, I would only be able to select one element, or I would have to enter rep to repeat the style for each element, because you can only select one element by id. You cannot have an id shared by more than one element. So that's when classes come into play. Class is another attribute that you can enter like so, and we can give all the vegetables a class called veggie. So if I copy that, I can give these guys here the same class, these guys here the same class. For the meats, I can give them a class that says meat, and I can repeat that as well in here. Now in CSS, I can refer to that class and give it a style, any style I want. For example, and you use that with a dot, start with a dot. So dot veggie, is it veggie or veggies? It's veggie. So dot veggie will have the following style. It will have a color of green. So that's already styling these elements here. What else can I do? I can also style the meat, and I can give it a color of brown. And that will give me a different color for these elements. So classes allow you to select multiple elements. You can also just select one, but you can also select many. So it's quite a powerful tool to use when you're doing CSS. And all of this has to do with the selection part. So now you know how to select by tag, you know how to select by ID, and you know how to select by class. Chrome Developer Tools, I want to show you that as well, has some interesting features for CSS. If I go here and click on inspect, it will bring up the element inspector, and that shows you as well what the classes are of each element. So once you start looking at real websites, you'll see that they all have classes IDs, because this is very used. It's used very often. And in here in styles, you can see as well what elements the element has, what styles that element has. So this part here is showing that it has that the veggie class has the color property of green. You can also deactivate it just to see what it looks like. Or you can add some more features here. You can add, for example, background and give it a background yellow. But none of this gets saved once you refresh the page. So it's just for you to try things out. You'll see other styles here, and all of these that say user agent style sheet are default styles. Your browser has default styles, so that things already look a little bit styled, like headings already look with a larger font than non-headings and things like that. And then if you go to computed, it's a summary of all the styles that apply to that element. So there will be more into this that we'll look at later, but this already shows you a few things you can do with the developer tools and how you can explore CSS on the right side on the styles section.